The Comic-Con season is officially upon us, so this week we're focusing on the conventions we think you should be checking out, including the LFCC, MCM and Thought Bubble, so stay with us for the lowdown on that. Firstly though, it's time to take a look at the week in Geek. In movie news, Fox seemed to be struggling as it announced this week that the reboot of Fantastic Four will be delayed by 2 months, and the Assassin's Creed movie has dropped off the release calendar altogether, signalling that the production is in serious trouble. But in more positive news for Fox, it was confirmed that X-Men spin-off Deadpool is definitely happening.
Rhymes the disease. Meet the cure.
Okay, not the cure, but more like a topical ointment that reduces swelling and itch.
Hi, Tom. Just call
me Angel. Oh. It's due for release on February the 12th, 2016, with Tim Miller set to direct. Tim Burton fans will be thrilled to see that the first trailer for his upcoming production, Big Eyes, has been released. It stars Amy Adams as Margaret Keane, an artist famous in the 50s and 60s for her unusual portraits.
You are the only living soul I can tell my secret to.
I painted every single one of them. Every big eye. Me. And no one will ever know but you.
Well, it's been a very exciting week for TV. The first episode of the much-anticipated Gotham premiered on Fox on Monday.
It's my new partner, Jim Gordon.
You have a little danger in your eye. I wonder what you plan to do with that.
You killed people before?
That was war.
This is war. We're at war.
What's your name?
My name's Bruce Wayne.
And the season 2 premiere of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. hits ABC this Wednesday.
Trip, we got eyes?
Now we do.
That's what I'm selling. Sure you'd like to see some credentials?
Agent Browning, for S.H.I.E.L.D. you seem awfully indifferent to who we are.
What you are is the highest bidder. Whether you're in it for profit or for Hydra doesn't concern me. Not anymore.
Tuesday saw the new Supernatural series Forever premiere on ABC, as well as the second series of Fox's Sleepy Hollow. In other TV news, we couldn't contain our excitement when Colin Farrell was confirmed, yes, confirmed, to be playing one of the detectives in the new series of True Detective. He made the revelation in Ireland's Sunday World newspaper and said he was very excited to be on board. At present, no other cast members have been confirmed, but Vince Vaughn, Amy Adams, Elizabeth Moss and Taylor Kitsch are all rumoured to be in talks. More on that one as soon as we hear it. And finally, news of another new superhero series, this time airing on CBN. They've confirmed that a new Supergirl series will be hitting screens soon. Produced by Berlanti Productions, who are the guys behind Arrow and The Flash, Supergirl will follow Superman's cousins Kara Zor-El after she escapes from planet Krypton and decides to break her silence and use her superpowers on Earth.
Know her. Supergirl.
To be honest, I'm not sure I've earned the right to wear this uniform, but I will.
In gaming news, Bungie has detailed 2 Destiny in-game events. The first, Combined Arms Crucible Playlist, was live over the weekend, and the second, called The Queen's Wrath, went live on Tuesday. Running until the 6th of October, the Queen's Wrath event sees the Awoken's ruler calling in a favour and throwing a few rewards your way, which may or may not include unique legendary and or rare gear. Square Enix have announced that no less than 4 new Final Fantasy titles are set for release in the future. Titled Final Fantasy VII G-Bike, Final Fantasy Agito, Final Fantasy Type-0 and Final Fantasy XV, all 4 trailers are available to view on Den of Geek.
Yama nuketara, sorosoro umi da yo ne.
待たせて悪いな。もうすぐだ。
In comics news, Gerard Way, aka the lead singer of My Chemical Romance, has announced that he's making his Marvel Comics debut next month with a mini-series reimagining of Spider-Man called Edge of Spider-Verse. The comic will star Penny Parker, an orphan who's adopted by the Heads of Government Project SPDR and is trained as a pilot. Previews of the mini-series are available to watch on IGN. It's been announced that Gary Whitter, the screenwriter who's fronting Gareth Edwards' standalone Star Wars film, has been hired by Fox to write a Hollywood adaptation of the Image comic series Starlight. According to The Hollywood Reporter, the story will follow Duke McQueen, a space hero who saved the world decades ago, though no one believes him today. In the present day, McQueen is living a quiet life on Earth, but is then recruited for one last adventure. In other comics news, it's been reported that Warner Brothers is making a Suicide Squad movie. According to Variety, they want David Ayer to direct from a script by Justin Marks.
Assemble Task Force X. We have another suicide mission.
Yahtzee! Now it's time to focus on the Comic-Con season to see what's in store for fans. Whether you're a die-hard MCM baby or a person who shudders at the thought of thousands of cartoon-clad enthusiasts crammed into an exhibition centre, there's sure to be something perfect for you this autumn.
I've been a lifelong Batman fan since I was knee-high to a grasshopper, so first Comic-Con, it only seemed right to come as Batman, really.
I've got a great rap!
Kicking off the season is the LFCC, which takes place on the 18th and 19th of October at Earl's Court. It's a sizeable convention, welcoming thousands each year, and it really places a focus on meeting the stars. If you want a selfie with Mindy Sterling or an autograph from Ralph Macchio, this is the Comic-Con for you. This year, expect appearances from Carrie Fisher, Billy Boyd, Katie Sackhoff, and Alberto Del Rio, to name a few. The LFCC is also notable for its wealth of UK creators who come to talk or exhibit every year. For tickets and information, visit the LFCC website, londonfilmandcomiccon.com. Next up, on the 24th, 20th,